Hi guys, welcome or welcome back. Thanks so much for joining me. Today we're going to go through exporting and preparing your images for Instagram. Hello there, fellow photographers. I'm Jess. I run this YouTube channel and basically I just kind of do like photography tips and stuff, release a video every single week here on YouTube. And then also we've got loads of different stuff going over on the website too. So if you care, go and have a look. But if not, don't worry about it. It would be great to see you here again. So hit the subscribe button, hit that bell icon. The bell icon gives you a notification every single time I upload a YouTube video. Okay, so that's that. Today we're going to go through a question that I get asked reasonably regularly. For those who are maybe not Instagram legends, posting to Instagram, especially with photography work, can be a little bit convoluted and confusing because of the different steps involved. So today we're going to go through a 10-step, sounds a lot, but it's really quite straightforward, step-by-step tutorial for posting your images on Instagram and retaining your original crop ratio. Okay, so let's get stuck in. I'm going to just kind of assume that we're going to meet together at this YouTube video when you finish your edit, okay? So you finish your edit in Photoshop, and we've basically got all of the layers still available, still visible on that side, which gives us our starting point, okay? So the first thing that I'm gonna want you to do is flatten your image. So we're gonna right click in the empty space next to a layer and choose flatten image. And when the image is flattened down to a single background layer, that's when we can kind of start looking at the adjustments that we need to make for social media. So number one is flatten. Number two, is it changed to 8-bit. Now you might already be working in 8-bit, but it's definitely worth a check. You want to go up into image, into mode, and make sure we're on 8-bits. Okay, so that is step number two. Step number three is to go into edit and go down to convert to profile. Now again, you might already be working in the correct profile for the internet, but if not, you want to go into convert to profile. Now in this window, you can see your current source and then a destination space. We're going to want to go into this list and find somewhere in that list one that says sRGB IEC 61966-2.1. Okay, it's sRGB. We click on sRGB. Leave your settings as they are here seen on this screen and then click OK. Now we're at the point where this could viably be a JPEG for the internet, but there's a few more steps, right? Because Instagram can only show portrait images to a maximum ratio of a 4:5 crop. Now I think this is a 4:5 crop. No, it's not. It's not a 4:5 crop. Do you see the little gap here? That would be completely lost on Instagram. So sometimes you might be posting portrait images that are actually really tall and really thin. And in those instances, you're kind of losing the rest of the image. So what we're going to go through is the next couple of steps is basically to prevent that from happening. So you're going to do one version, which is going to be on the front. That's like the full feed. Then we're going to do a carousel, because the second image is going to be uncropped, right? So perfect for monthly challenges, just saying. So I want you to stop here where we are now. We're flattened, we've converted, we're in 8-bit, okay? At this point, I want you to go and find your watermark. There's a video all about that. And pop that somewhere near the subject, okay? So that is step number four. I'm going to go ahead and find my watermark over here in libraries. That is in that tutorial I just mentioned, by the way. And we're going to place it close to the subject, okay? And then I'm going to switch it to soft light and turn it down. So it's like basically barely visible, but it exists. So when you get to here, I'm going to want you to go ahead again and flatten this image off, right? So we're going to flatten the image. And now we're at the point where we can start creating our little formats. To do this and to do this easily, I like to just create two copies of the same image. So we're going to go up into image and then choose duplicate. And what this is going to do basically is it's going to make an exact copy of this file. So this one is going to be our Instagram cropped. So I'm going to call it IG cropped, right? With IG cropped, this is a separate file, okay? And then I'm going to go into image and duplicate it again and do IG full. So we've got now three copies, one the original, One we've named it, but it's exactly the same, and the other one we've named it and it's exactly the same. So that is step number 5, I wanna say. I think we're on step number 5. Stick with me here. Okay, step number 6 is to get your crop for your cropped version. So we're gonna go for the crop tool. If your image is landscape, go for a square. If your image is portrait, go for a 4-5 crop, because that gives you the best that you can get. So we're gonna go for a 4-5 crop in the ratio. What you need to bear in mind if you're doing your portrait ones, by the way, top tip, is that this is gonna crop square anyway. So afterwards on your personal grid, it's gonna crop square. So I'm kind of keeping in mind the fact that we're gonna have some croppage on the top and bottom. So I'm gonna go for a 4-5 crop and bring it in on all sides just slightly. Okay, this is fine. So that is my cropped version. Then I'm gonna go back to my other image, which is IG full. I'm gonna keep the same crop ratio, okay? So if you were square, you stay square. If you were 4-5, you stay 4-5. Then what we're gonna do is click once, and instead of cropping in, we're gonna crop out. So we're gonna pull out and pull out. So essentially, Photoshop is having to add pixels somewhere, right? I'm gonna make sure that the delete cropped pixels is on, okay? Delete cropped pixels is on, just because it keeps it nice and straightforward for you. And then your background color down here, that is the color that is being filled in. I'm just gonna flip it so we can see the empty space around the edges and click okay. So that's locked in now, it's a 4-5, it's cropped, but we've got the additional space on the side. I'll include some other examples on the screen now of images that have had this treatment to basically give you a flavor of what it ends up being like. So now we've got a cropped version for the grid and a full version for the carousel. So then, all we need to do is go ahead and resize it because we've done everything else. So I think we're on like step 8 now, but Dan will correct me if I'm wrong by putting the right numbers at the bottom here. But we're gonna just go ahead and resize, and the resizing is exactly the same for both. So we're gonna go to image, image size, and then in the dialog box that comes up, we're gonna make sure that the longest side, so pick the longest side, the biggest number here, we want to keep an eye on that. That's our target. But first, we go to resolution and we change it to 200. Then we find the biggest number, longest side, and we change it to 2000 pixels. That gives us our Instagram-sized image. We then do the exact same thing on the other one. Image, image size, 200 pixels per inch, longest side pixels, height, 2000. That gives us Instagram sized images. Then all that's left to do is save that out. So we're going to go to file, save as, and find where you want to save it. Okay, we'll go into here, this is fine. And I'm going to call it Frecky IG full, and then it needs to be saved as a JPEG. And then the JPEG, we need to make sure we're embedding the color profile, very important. Then we come onto this little screen here. Have preview checked, and your aim is to have this number under 1000. So this is absolutely fine. This is like teeny weeny. I'm gonna go with full quality. Usually 10 is good, okay? We click okay on that one. That one is then saved. I can close it, and then this one, we go file, save as. I go to the same location, I call it Frecky IG cropped, we change it to a JPEG, it's got the color profile embedded, we click save. This one is still well under 1000 kilobytes, and then we click okay. Now we need to go prep the post for Instagram, okay? So let me grab my phone. So what I need to then do is transfer this to my phone. Now, if you use an iPhone, okay, there will be other variations, but I know the iPhone one, you need to transfer these images. Super easy. Find the images in your folder, select them so that they're both selected, right click, choose share, and then choose airdrop. Up on the screen there, you'll then have essentially a list of people. Make sure your phone's unlocked. Then you go ahead and click the iPhone version of whatever comes up in AirDrop, and automatically the images will be sent to your phone. Perfect, right? So then all we need to do is go ahead, whiz over to Instagram. And when we're on Instagram, we can go ahead and add a new post. And this is the point where you need to get your portrait images correct, okay? So we're gonna do a carousel. So to post and retain your crop, you just hit the little arrows down in the bottom corner. So I'll do that on an image where you can see. So it crops it square, But if you want to retain your 4-5 that you've already set, then you just go ahead and press those little that little button in the bottom left. If not, we're going to do a carousel anyway. So we click the front image, the image that was on the feed, and then we hit the little arrows to make sure it's the full one. Then we hit the boxes over the top of each other. I mean, you know what I mean. And then we hit the second image, which has everything in full. And so what that does is it gives us a carousel that retains the crop ratio so that you can see everything you want to see on Instagram. We then click next, and then that is essentially your preview of what you're going to see. So then you click next, fill in the post, hashtag what you want to hashtag, and then you can go ahead and share. Quite straightforward, really quite simple. I'll include a blog post with all of those different things below, and also I'll include a set of Photoshop actions for the MTogs as well, which basically does all of this in warp speed, so you don't have to worry about any of it. That will be linked in the blog post too. I hope this was helpful for you guys. I'll see you all again next week. See you on Friday. See you soon.